Hey everyone, welcome back to Get Ready With Me. How are you doing? And I hope you guys have been enjoying the beautiful weather. I've been taking advantage and spending some time with some friends and some family. And so I created a video about let's say about 2 weeks ago. I was trying to do a peacock look. And I did the whole video and everything. It's just my lighting was so off and disgusting that I just decided that I wasn't going to post it. So I waited for my ipsy bag and my boxycharm and a sugar face package to come in before going ahead and doing this makeup look. So I've already prepped. So we are watching this video to see how I attain this upcoming makeup look. This stuff is great. So guys, if you ever get the chance, I truly suggest purchasing this. This costs $35 and it's from Eliminis Natural, Au Naturel. I think my skin looks pretty good. I'm anxious to see how it's going to go with, the makeup application. So to switch it up, instead of using a moisturizer after I cleanse my face, I moisturize every single day, twice a day. I decided to go with one of these little samples that I got in my ipsy bag. It is from Feel and it's called Bright Squalene Facial Oil Rosehip and Avocado Oil Blend for All Skin Types. So this is supposed to be compatible with oily skin, which is what I am. My skin, I guess it would be good because it's going to trick my skin into producing less oil today because I just put oil on. However, I don't like the shininess, but it is oil, so I have to give it a chance. I really love this stuff, and I swear by it. Dr. Brandt, you were one of my favorite products. This is one of my favorite products, so... And I got this in my FabFitFun, the spring box. However, I did cancel my subscription because it took almost a month. And then by the month came up, like the payment for my second box was going through. And, you know, it's only supposed to be $39.99 or $49.99 a month for products, but because I'm in Canada, and the exchange rate, I did not pay that. I actually almost paid $100 to get that box. So, and it's maybe $150 worth of products. So I'm just going to go in and it looks like this. It has an orange tint to it, but it does not go on with an orange tint, as you guys can see. I just go blot that right in. I like to prep. So now I'm gonna prep my eyelids and I'm gonna use, so I'm gonna go in with the Morphe 35N palette. It looks like this. I absolutely love Morphe eyeshadows. The pigmentation is, I absolutely love the pigmentation. They're very nice, very blendable, and they're extremely pigmented. So, it's just to get that all over the lid. I'm going to go in with my Urban Studio Fluffy Brush. And I purchased these at Winners. They were on special for $69.99 for the kit. And... I do have to say, I absolutely love these brushes. I love the way they work. So I'm just going to show you what I'm doing. So my base color is between these two right here. And I'm using that to put, if I can find it, my Tarte palette that I got in last month's Boxy. I am obsessed. I'm a little disappointed, however, because this keeps popping off. But you know, it's the least of the the problems. So I'm going into this palette right here, and I'm going to grab Sunbeam. This is it's called Explore. My bad. And I'm going to go in with my angled fluffy brush from Becky. I still can't get over the smell of this palette. Oh my god. Always tap off the excess. Tarte is also very pigmented, and I love their shadows. So I'm just going to go into my crease and give it some dimension. And it will be also used for... And your transition shade can be buildable. However, I don't want to go too deep with that color because we are using multiple colors today. So now, this is the GA three-piece brush set. And look at those bristles. They are so beautiful. I love the pink. Very, very beautiful set. And I absolutely love Luxie brushes. So this one is the Luxie 250 Large Eye Blending Brush. And I'm just going to go in and smoothen that out. When you blend, you want to be sure that you use a clean brush. There we go. So now that we've created our crease, I'm going to go in with, I'm going to go into that color, tap up the excess, and go right back in here. And really... define that. Now, a lot of people have asked me where I got my Morphe palettes, because we do have a store in the Cornwall Mall from Showcase. I don't trust those type of stores because it's one of those stores that receive a lot of things that you don't get in the others. It's I guess you can call it kind of a discount store, and those online stores. I don't go there. I prefer ordering directly from the company, and that's exactly what I did with my Morphe palettes. Alright, so now that we've gotten that darkened up, I'm going to go in now with, and I received this one in my BoxyCharm also. It's called Butter from London. It's a beautiful palette, and I got to use it on the Mayor. Look at those colors. The packaging is super cute, and I still have the tissue right on it, but those are beautiful. So now I'm going to go in with this guy right here called Femme Fatale, and I'm going to pop that so it is a matte color, and I'm going to go in with my Luxie 239 Precision Shader, and I love love. So this color is buildable. It's not a strong pigment when you first put it on, which is good. It gives you a little more control if you are not used to high pigmented shadows. So now I'm going to go in with my Firma 201 and I'm going to blend right into here. I really don't like harsh edges. And we're just going to blend that into right in there. And I'm going to use this bad boy right here, Daybreak. And I'm going to go in with my Urban Studio, another Urban Studio brush. Tap the access, and I'm going to go right in there. And now I'm just going to go back in with, where did my brush go? I'm going to go in with another Becky brush. It's another angled fluffy brush. And I'm going to go back and use that color that we used for the crease in that Morphe palette and put some more back in there. So now I'm going to go back into with my Firma blending brush. I'm just going to blend the lid out just a little more because I find it a little harsh. And we want that to be as soft as possible. I know it looks chaotic right now. It will look good, I promise. All right, so now I'm going to go into that bottom light transition color that we used the first time. And we're just gonna get that bottom. Use my Luxie Precision Crease 246, and I'm gonna go in there and put on some green and some purple. This is a very intense eye look, and I find this is a very funny transition. Okay, so now I'm gonna go in with the star, and get that onto the bottom lash line as well. I'm just going with my Lise Wattier right on top of that because my concealer is too lightweight. Now I'm going to use my, I always struggle with this palette, my Cover Effects, and I'm going to use the highlighter right over here, and I'm going to pop those into the corner. And to do that, I'm going to use, and I got this from facesugar, it's still in the package, so I don't know how well this works yet. It feels... I like the way it looks. But it feels very light. I find it feels a little cheap. It's from INM with a little heart. I'm not sure. I don't know if you guys can see that. Yeah. So, I don't know. We'll see. Doesn't look like anything's going on. Okay, let's improvise here. Let's get out of the cover effects. What about in the London? Yeah, I'm gonna go into the Natural Goddess palette, and I'm gonna try the Enchantress and see. Oh, that works a little better. Again, these colors are buildable, which is... So I'm going to go in with my first initial blending brush, and I'm going to go and soften everything up. A lot better. However, we're still not done with the eyes. I am gonna go back in here with that other color. I just find sometimes when you start blending things out, you can tend to lose some of the initial pigmentation from the first colors. Right into there and right in here. Okay, so now that our shadow is pretty much done, I'm going to go in with Bye Bye Under Eye, and I'm going to clean that up, and I'm going to go in, and I'm going to bring it up and just sharpen up that line. And like I showed you in the last video, really a little goes a long way. This is less than a pea size amount. So I'm going to go in with my Clean Beauty Blender, and I'm just going to pounce that out and bring it up. Alright, now I'm going to go with my little concealer brush, and I'm going to go in and just... That's not working out so well. Just go there. And I'm just going to give myself like a... guide. Okay. And I'm going to go in with my eyeliner from, if I can find it, Ico. Super pigmented. I love this stuff. I don't do liners very often. So it's marker-like. Because even to you. That looks even to me. Now, I don't do eyeliners very often because... So I'm just going to go in, and I got these in my BoxyCharm. They are spot cleansing water wipes. This is from an actual facial line, which is the only reason why I'm going to use them, because otherwise I do not use facial wipes because they have a lot of drying agents. The eye area alone, and now I'm going to go in and do my face, and then we're going to go back and pop in some lashes and do my brows. So I'm going to go back in with my color correctors, and I like to use color correctors for build looks. For the simple fact is, when you do big looks, there's so much time and effort that you're putting into it, and you don't want any fly, like, you don't want to defy the whole purpose of your look. The Lauder Double Wear in nude. Always keep in mind to shake your products, especially your foundation. You want to get the full effect. So I'm just going to pop this at the back of my hand, and I'm going to pounce it on my face. And get the neck. A little goes a long way, and you can control how much you want to build with Estee Lauder. I really enjoy Estee Lauder for that. I do have to say, this has been one of the best foundations I've ever used. And I swear by it. However, everybody has their personal choices. For me, it is Estee Lauder. It's very pricey, but it's... I think it's worth the price. With my concealer. And pop that right there. Bridge of the nose. My cupid area. Sort of the mouth. Because I do get dark there. And we're gonna pop that right there. I know this looks like a lot of product, but this is very lightweight. And it just looks worse than what it is. Get that area right there. And here. And here. And we're gonna blend that out. And I like to go a little further because I do have an oval face. I don't need to go nuts with it, but I like to blend it out as much as I can. And I don't mind going crazy in this area because I do find myself a little dark there. And just like that. One of my students must be so proud of me. I am thoroughly against baking. However, this product, Ciate Extraordinaire, which I brought up in my last video, I actually like their product, and I like the way it sits, and I find it gives me a little more flexibility to do that, and I like them a lot. And I got the big one. The first time I got it was in my Ipsy bag, and then I got my full-size one in my FabFitFun box. There we go. All right. I'm gonna let that bake for a little bit. Please excuse me. It looks like I'm just not gonna go there. All right, so now I'm gonna go into contouring my face, and I'm gonna go in with my NYX palette. It's the HCPP01 Highlighting Contour Pro Palette, and I absolutely love, 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 love the NYX Contour Palette. It has not let me down. So I am going to pop my brush with my crown brush. I'm going to go in and grab the S06 right over here. That's called Toffee Caramel. And I'm gonna go and define that crease right in there. And always keep in mind to go towards your hairline and blend upwards. And then I'm going to go right underneath the jawline. I like to define the jawline. And I bring it into a V here, and it just slims everything down. I'm gonna get those right into the hair corners right here, and bring that down along the hairline. Underneath. Right in there. Beautiful. Here I go again with the beautiful stuff. Okay. So I'm going to give this a few more minutes. So now I'm going to go in with my bronzer from Lisa Frank. I'm obsessed. Look at this packaging. I can't get over it. It's so freaking cute. I absolutely love it. So it's a mattifying bronzer. And Bitten and Bronze. I'm going to take my Urban Studio Fluffy Brush. Blush Brush. Fluffy Bronzer. Fluffy Brush. And I'm just going to go in. Get that sun-kissed look. Bring it back into the ears. Into the neck. blush today, I will be using the Phase Zero blusher. That's what it's called, blusher. And I received this in this month's Ipsy bag. I have not tried it yet, but it's very pretty. And I'm going to go in with my Urban Studio angled blush brush. And I'm just going to work that into the apples of my cheeks and blend it into my bronzer. It's got a bit of a shimmer. So, I do everything with a light hand. You don't want to disturb the product underneath. Nice and subtle. I like it. And now I'm going to remove this powder. So I'm going to go in with my Firma 103 brush. And I like to use this brush to remove powder. It's very nice and fluffy. It's very light. And another way to help with removing your setting powder is to dip the brush into the product again, so you are not moving and you're not pulling onto the skin. And you just lightly glide and dust that off. And it leaves like a nice airbrush finish. Alright, so now that I've completed that, I'm going to go in and pop some highlighter from Ofra, and this is called Rodeo Drive. Ofra, that's what's up. And I like to pop highlighters with my fingers. I don't like using brushes to pop highlighter. You put that right on top of your zygomatics. Pop that right here onto the frontalis. And before I continue with, alright, here on the Cupid's bow. So before I continue with my highlighter, I'm going to go in and I'm going to contour my nose. So I'm going to go in with my Becky pointed brush and I'm going to go back in into that coffee caramel color. A little trick to contour your nose, look downwards so you can see where your nose lines up. So I like to go from the top of the nose and I go down into one straight line. Back down again. And we're just gonna go point it downwards just like that. And I like to define this area as well. No, I'm just gonna go in and I'm gonna just blend it out just a little bit. And I'm gonna grab my highlighter. Just put that at the tip of my nose and right on the bridge right here. Alright, so now that I got all this done on my face, I'm going to go in and I'm going to grab my Becky brush and I'm going to go in with a yellow, that yellow color in my, and it's called Soft Light. And I'm just going to pop that right into my under eye area. Bring that up right here. So, alright, so now that contour is done, I'm going to set this in place, and today I'm going to be using Paladio Forever and Ever Makeup Setting Spray Long Lasting Matte Finish with Aloe, Botanicals, and Vitamin Infused. Give it a good shake. Spray that in. And then when I set, like when I spray to set, I go in with my blender and I dab it in. It helps push the product in and make the skin look more skin-like, and it helps to blend. Just gonna Alright. Now we're done that. And now I'm gonna do my brows. And I'm gonna be using today, where's my Adele brush? I'm gonna be using Milani Dark Brown Stay Put Brow in 05. So it's a dark brown. I'm just gonna go in and brush these upwards. And I'm gonna start right here and I literally do, I think I do my eyebrows so much that I don't even think, I don't know, I like to do hairline strokes right through, it's my only tip that I can really give you guys for your eyebrows, try to do hairline strokes, and take your time with it at first. I literally do my eyebrows every single day. So I don't even think, like, I can go full face without makeup. I need to have my brows. And it's not like I don't have a decent set of brows. It's just when you're I hate the sparse areas. And I like to have full brows. So I'm just gonna go define the bottom. And quite surprisingly, my favorite brush to do my eyebrows is the Ardell brush. It has the spoolie at the end here and the angled bristles. I absolutely love it. I feel like I have more control. I would purchase just the brush itself. So we got nice big eyebrows today. Usually I don't do them this thick. But I like to switch it up once in a while. So now I'm going to go in with my little concealing brush. And I'm just going to clean up that line right underneath the brow. Right there. I'm just going to use my beauty blender. I like to use my beauty blender for underneath. It helps, I find, to blend it out. Sharpen up those edges. Alright, so now I'm going to move into my waterline. I'm going to pop on some lashes and get some lips on. So for the... I'm going to be going in with a Marcel Hyperallergenic Kohl Eyeliner in beige. I really like using a beige liner. I find it brightens up the eye. And it just makes your eye look healthy. Okay. So I'm going to pop in some lashes, and today I'll be using Alright, so now that I got these lashes on, I'm going to go in and I'm just going to give them like a nice little... I find it helps alleviate any heaviness and curls them up for you. I just find that it gives a better feel to the eye. So clearly this one is driving me nuts. Alright, so I'm going to go in with this Larcity pencil. I got this in my facesugar package. It's called Retro Red. The cap feels cheap. It feels like a dollar store pencil, almost. I know this is kind of rude, but I'm not trying to be I'm just trying to be honest with my reviews and what I actually really think of the product. However, just because it feels this way doesn't mean it's going to be good, so I'm going to give it a shot. All right, so what I did is I went in with my, with the Larceny crayon, and then I went over with Huda Beauty liquid matte in shade Crush, and I popped on my Italia Deluxe lip pencil to get this color, which I think it looks great. And now I'm going to pop more of that Ofra highlighter right on the top, right here. And I'll pop some right here. This is the finished product. So if you like this look, please give this video a thumbs up. And if you don't, well, please say so and tell me what I can do better for you guys. Thanks, guys. See you in the next video. Bye.